I was surprised to learn that China holds dedicated traditional sports events for people from different ethnic groups. The equestrian events of the 12th National Traditional Games of Ethnic Minorities of the People's Republic of China are being held in Zhaosu, Xinjiang, with all the events requiring the participation of horses and camels. Teams from Xinjiang, Inner Mongolia, Xizang, Qinghai, and other regions of China showcase their talent in horseback archery, picking up a header while sitting on a horseback, horseback acrobatics, and more. Riding a horse is already quite challenging for me, not to mention seeing them perform acrobatics on a galloping horse. It's simply amazing!
This event is called Gunyang Drag. It means like following the girls or girls following the boys. It's a traditional Kazakh people way of dating. So what's the point? When the girl, if she likes the boy, she will start whipping him gently. But if she doesn't like him, she will start whipping him with a force.
This is a Mongolian camel polo game. Playing polo on camels looks twice as difficult as on horses. What if the camel doesn't cooperate? Then there is the sheep grabbing game, where two teams on horseback compete for a sheep. Riding a horse while trying to grab a sheep, these games seem even harder than basketball or soccer. While I was walking around the field, I saw two people in the distance. It seemed that they were wrestling with their horses.
Hello, hello. What's your name? Xiaohui.
Even though we had just met for the first time, Iran kindly lent me his horse. With Lashan's help, I tried some horseback stunts for the first time. Lashan and Iran are Kazakhs from Zhaosu. They participated in the opening ceremony of the games. Unlike me, they performed everything on the stage.
Okay,
so I'm not a professional. Wow.
Wow. Oh, right.
When it was time to say goodbye, Lashan invited me to watch her equestrian performance. Even though she is still an intern with her performance team, she has already found her future goal.
未来梦想就是一直就这样骑着马，让整个世界知道我是真正的哈萨克姑娘，让他们知道一下怎么让一匹马这么好。After
saying farewell to Lashan, I headed to Iran's place. He had a horse ready for me in advance, wanting to show me the scenery at his homeland.
Hello, 男生，hello，
我今天想的是回趟家来着，还是很开心见到你了啊！这是我奶奶啊，奶奶好啊！啊，这是我妈妈。哎，hello，hello，客人亲近啊，真的吗？有这种啊，就是先是客人进，然后就是家人。哇，这么多的美食啊！哇，这都是对给我们准备的吗？啊，是。哇塞，好开心啊！客人上座一般，啊，这是布尔萨克，
布尔萨克，
那就用手对吧？用手啊，对。
原来是面包，对吧？就是那种感觉。对，昨天突然下雨了。啊，对，下雨了，然后我们觉得这里的天气变化太快了，真的是。有些人还调侃说，高速的天气跟牛人一样，说一遍。
对，我们看到好像那个下大雨一场雨，然后就那个很好看的一种。 就是那个彩虹出来了。然后对，你们经常会看到这种，
会看到，
就是这个角度，
有错，彩虹就在眼前，有错就特别远。
哇，哇，哪儿这个东西？
马甲。
马甲。哦。哇，这个图案真美了。哇，
快点站起来。
怎么？
啊，看不，我看不。
How about a jala spirit of body?
The eyelids of the eyes.
Oh. 谢谢谢谢奶奶，自己的妻子有什么样的要求？你希望她能 找到什么样的女孩？
天哪，你说话，看待我是什么？我找不到的地方怎么办？我不想找死。
像我妈妈那样，
有点温柔的，对吧？这样，就是照顾家，对吧？
孝，
孝顺啊，孝顺。
After finding out that I love singing and dancing, Iran called his friends and brought out a traditional Kazakh instrument, the dombra.
这是我们哈萨克的民族乐器，咚不拉，
咚不拉。
用右手拨动我们的这个两个线，就发出声音。哈萨克就是用我们的咚不拉来，表示我们自己的心情呀。
啊，那比如说，如果你现在就是心情。不是特别好，对吧？难过的时候，你可以
难过的时候就，
对，你就可以去。哦，就是这个有点那种浪漫的那种难过感觉，就是那种，哎呀，那为什么就是失恋了，对吧？就这个这个曲，
对，都有。
好，那开心了
啊，
有个开心开心。哦，也不太会跳，但是我觉得就是一听到就想跳舞，对吧？挺有意思，还有妈妈对吧？他们都会，他们都会跳舞，可以教我一下吗？
哇，这个有点复杂。草原
After 3 hours of riding, we finally arrived at Iran's summer pasture, placed deep in the Tianshan Mountains. Herds of cattle and sheep roamed freely on the grassland, and the incredible views made me feel completely relaxed. A small house hidden deep in the mountains.Sounds like a fairy tale, isn't it? But actually, that's the house where Iran's uncle lives with his family during summer. Iran's sister and her children were looking forward for my arrival. The children are especially excited to see a stranger suddenly appearing in the distance. The kids thought I was a Barbie doll who had come to visit them and even asked their mom if I was a rabbit.They were so adorable, calling me Princess Melissa.
哇，是给我的！哇，谢谢，好好看哦。这是什么呢？你知道吗？这是你们民族的服装。
看看看看，
看看啊，好，来看。哇，真的，谢谢谢谢啊，这样才是。你看，哎呀，好看。
哈萨克语里面有一句话就是说，马是男人的翅膀。
嗯，哇，真美啊！我觉得很文学的那种说法，对吧？
开心的时候也可以骑着它转一圈，你难过了也可以骑着它跑一圈，你也就放松多了。
那你以后呢？
每个村庄都需要。像我们这样青年一样发展他们，不管你走到哪儿，你出生地方对你来说是不一样的，最重要的
主要是要珍惜你所有的东西，对吧？你就是围绕着你的这片土地。
我希望通过自己努力去推广自己家乡的民情，虽然偏僻吧，但是我相信总有一天很多人都会发现这儿民情。
I hope that you enjoyed listening to our stories and watching the views and sights here in Xinjiang.
And I hope that once you have an opportunity to get here on your own with your friends and your family. So keep watching our programs and following incredible China programs. See you next time. Bye-bye. Woohoo!